गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द लेसन रिसोर्सेज एंड डेवलपमेंट। कैन यू आइडेंटिफाई एंड नेम द वेरियस आइटम्स यूज्ड इन मेकिंग लाइफ कंफर्टेबल इन आवर विलेजेस एंड टाउन्स? इट इज़ वेरी सिंपल, यू कैन लिस्ट दोज आइटम्स इन विच पीपल लिविंग इन विलेज एंड टाउन्स दे मेक्स देयर लाइफ कंफर्टेबल बाई यूजिंग वेरियस टाइप ऑफ रिसोर्सेज, दैट इज़ नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज। For example, in villages, people uses forest products, agricultural products to earn their livings, along with that to survive. They have many types of kaccha house, pakka house in villages, and they are using various types of resources. On the other hand, in towns, people are using electrical equipments, they are natural resources and man-made resources, and along with this they are using water resources, solar energy and so many things. So we should first try to understand what is resource, because resource help us to develop. Everything available in our environment which can be used to satisfy our needs, provided it is technologically accessible, economically feasible and culturally acceptable, can be termed as resource. Means environment, we are living in on earth and it has an environment which is suitable for living beings. So whatever things are available in this area which can be used to satisfy our needs, means those things which are found in environment, if satisfy our needs and if they are technologically accessible, means technology has been developed to use those resources, and if it is economically feasible, means if it comes in our pocket, we afford it, it is not so costly that we cannot use it, and culturally acceptable, all cultures if accept it, then such things are known as resources. So it is the definition of resource, means everything available in our environment which can be used to satisfy our needs, provided it is technologically accessible, economically feasible and culturally acceptable, can be termed as resources. Now we will talk about interdependent relationship between nature, technology and institutions. We people as a human being, we interact with nature. We take help of technology what we have developed by earning knowledge, and we make institutions, and with the help of institutions, technology and nature, we perform development activities and we have done economical development. And we are better civilized now. The process of transformation of things available in our environment involves an interactive relationships between nature, technology and institutions. Means it is a process of transformation of things. If you know things are can be transformed by certain process, then and if there is a in relationship between interaction between nature, technology and institutions, then we can do economical development. Human beings interact with nature through technology, means human being have developed a technology. With the help of that, it interact with nature and create institutions. What are institutions? Manufacturing institutions, marketing institutions and consumer institutions. And they accelerate their economic development. Means by interaction of human being with technology, nature and institutions makes economic development. Means it increases the speed of economic development if interactions are properly done. Now, do you think the resources are free gifts of nature as is assumed by many? Means on the earth, many types of natural resources are grown up. We can say that forest products, many types of living beings which are eatables, such as fisheries, livestock, are they free gifts of nature? Can we assume it as a free gift of nature? Of course, on one hand, it is free gift, but we should have technology to make it useful for us. They are not free because human activities, they are responsible for it. Human activities, they are depleting them. Resources are a function of human activities. We can say that whatever resources are there, they grow or exhaust on the basis of human activities. Human beings themselves are essential components of resources. Means we as a human beings, we are also a resource. If we are skilled, we are talented, we are healthy, then we can do economic development fastly, and we can perform all such activities easily and in efficient manner. They transform material available in our environment into resources and use them. Human beings, by earning extra knowledge, technology, training, they use materials and transform them into useful things, whatever found in our environment. These resources can be classified in the following ways. Means we can classify resources on various bases. First one is on the basis of origin. Means on the basis of origin, resources are biotic and abiotic. On the basis of exhaustibility, resources are renewable and non-renewable. Exhaustibility means the thing which will exhaust or finished after certain time. Third one is on the basis of ownership. On the basis of ownership, resources are divided into four categories. First one is individual resource, second one is community resource, third one is national resource, and fourth one is international resource. On the basis of status of development, potential developed stock and reserves, means on the basis of status of development, resources are divided into four types: potential, developed stock and reserves. Children, we can make it its flowchart that has been printed in your NCERT book. Resources are divided into two parts. First one is natural resource and second one is human resource. Okay, natural resources are further divided into two parts: renewable resources, non-renewable resources. And renewable resources are divided into two parts: continuous or flow, example wind and water, and biological. Second one is, after that, biological resources are divided into natural vegetation, that is forest and wildlife. If we continue towards non-renewable resources, they are of two types: recyclable, example metals, and non-recyclable, example fossil fuels. If we consider second resource, that is human resource, human resources are divided into two parts: structures and institutions, and quantity and quality. So this is your classification of resources. If we continue towards second page, then we will come across types of resources on the basis of origin. On the basis of origin, we have already explained resources are of two types: biotic resource, abiotic resources. Biotic resources, these are obtained from biosphere. Means biotic resources दे आर ऑब्टेंड फ्रॉम बायोस्फीयर वेयर ऑल लिविंग बींग्स परफॉर्म देयर लाइफ साइकिल. बायोस्फीयर इज दैट एरिया वेयर ऑल लिविंग बींग्स परफॉर्म देयर लाइफ साइकिल एंड हैव लाइफ सच एज ह्यूमन बींग्स. वी पीपल्स कम्स इन द कैटेगरी ऑफ बायोटिक रिसोर्सेज. फ्लोरा एंड फौना. फ्लोरा एंड फौना मीन्स means plant bodies, plant kingdom, and fauna means animal kingdom. Then comes fisheries. Fishes you know very well. So fisheries also falls in the category of biotic resources. Another one is livestock. Livestock means every types of domestic animals as well as consumable animals such as goats, pigs, cock, etc. If we consider abiotic resources, we will come across all those things which are composed of non-living things are called abiotic resources. Means everything available on earth that are made up of non-living things. For example, rocks. Then we have various types of minerals, metals. All this comes in the category of abiotic resources. So this was the classification of resources on the basis of origin. If we come across its classification on the basis of exhaustibility. Exhaustibility means resources will exhaust after some time. Means on basis of this, resources are divided into two categories. Renewable resources means the resources which will get renewed, means which will again formed, means the resources which can be renewed or reproduced by physical, chemical or mechanical processes, means those resources which can be reproduced, that is renewed by physical methods, chemical methods and by using mechanical processes, they are known as renewable or replenishable, means can be obtained again. Such resources are called replenishable resources also. For example, solar energy, solar, wind energy, water, forest and wildlife, they can be replenished, they can be reproduced once again. So the renewable resources may further be divided into continuous or flow. Means renewable resources may be continuous or flow. Okay. Now we will talk about non-renewable resources. These occur over a very long geological time. Means non-renewable resources, they takes long time to be formed once again. For example, minerals and fossil fuels found in our earth crust, means which is available under our earth, it is formed after long processing and long geological time. It takes a long period of time. These resources take millions of years in their formation. For example, coal, petroleum, all these, you know, minerals, all these fossil fuels, they takes lot of time to be formed. Some of the resources like metals are recyclable, because when we use metals, then we can also, you know, recycle it. Tin container, various type of metallic things, they can be recycled. And some like fossil fuels cannot be recycled, such as petroleum, coal, they cannot be obtained again and get exhausted with their use. When we used it, it is exhausted, nothing remained. But metals can be recycled, but once metals are oxidized, they can also not be renewed. So it comes in the category of non-renewable resources. Now on the basis of ownership, we can classify resources on the basis of ownership. On the basis of ownership, resources are divided into individual resources, community owned resources, नेशनल रिसोर्सेज एंड इंटरनेशनल रिसोर्सेज. सो वी विल डिस्कस वन बाय वन. इंडिविजुअल रिसोर्सेज मीन्स अ इंडिविजुअल पर्सन, मीन्स अ मैन और लेडी और एनी वन, अ सिंगल पर्सन हु ओन सच थिंग्स, हु द रिसोर्सेज विच इज ओन्ड बाय इंडिविजुअल मीन्स पर्सनल, मीन्स दीज आर ऑल्सो ओन्ड प्राइवेटली, इट इज़ आवर प्राइवेट प्रॉपर्टी by individuals, means we can use, everybody have some private things. Many farmers own land which is allotted to them by government against the payment of revenue. Most of the farmers, especially in our country, they own land. So many farmers own land means, and these lands are allotted by them by government against the payment of revenue, means they have to pay revenue for that. In villages there are people with land ownership. If we go across village area, we will have many people who tells that this is my piece of land, this is another person's piece of land, that is they had land ownership. But there are many who are landless. We have seen many people who are landless, means they don't have piece of land, they perform as a casual labor, constructional laborers, and they used to earn from working as a labor in factories. Urban people, those people who used to live in city, they own plots. If they are government servants, if they are businessmen, they have purchased plots, they have made houses and they used to live in that, and they have many other properties such as truck, bikes and you know, cooler, fridge. So all these comes in the category of individual, means it is owned by a single person. Plantation work, pasture lands, ponds, water in wells, etc. are some of the examples of resources ownership. Means pasture land where people used to feed their cattle. Ponds means a small water bodies where some aquatic animals survive, and village area people, they used to perform fishery work and other things. And water in wells, in olden time people used wells. The well water was used for their water purpose. They are some other examples of resources ownership by individuals, means they can be owned by a single body. Similarly, we can make another things list. Then we come across community owned resources. Community owned resources means which is owned by certain communities, such as Hindu community, Islamic community, Sikh community. So such resources can be community owned. There are resources which are accessible to all the members of the community. There are many types of resources which is used by members of the community. Village commons, there are many things which are used in villages by common people, such as grazing grounds, means there are some left piece of ground where grasses are grown and people can feed their cattle, they can graze their cattle in this ground. Burial grounds, where after death people had to be buried, that is burial grounds. In Hindi we say kabristan. Village ponds, there are some ponds, there are ponds in a village, they are used by community of the village. Public parks in urban area, if we come across cities, there are various types of parks, such as in Ambedkar Nagar there is Ambedkar Parks. Similarly, picnic spots, if we go in Lucknow we have Kokrail picnic spots. So and then playgrounds in urban area, many types of playgrounds are made in urban areas and they are used by common, means they are de facto accessible, means they can be used by everyone टू ऑल द पीपल लिविंग देयर मीन्स दोस एनीबडी हु आर लिविंग देयर दे कैन यूज कम्युनिटी ओन्ड रिसोर्सेज. नाउ वी कम्स द थर्ड वन अंडर दिस कैटेगरी इज नेशनल रिसोर्सेज मीन्स टेक्निकली इफ वी टॉक अबाउट इट साइंटिफिकली वी विल फाइंड दैट ऑल द रिसोर्सेज बिलोंग टू द नेशन वट एवर थिंग्स आर देयर इट बिलोंग्स टू आवर कंट्री दैट इज इंडिया एंड अक्रॉस द बाउंड्री ऑफ दिस कंट्री अनदर कंट्री इज देयर अनदर नेशन इज देयर सो द कंट्री हैज लीगल पावर्स टू अक्वायर इवन प्राइवेट प्रॉपर्टी फॉर पब्लिक गुड मीन्स एवरी कंट्री that has legal powers that is accepted by law that means law has given a country a power to acquire even a private property for public use means government can use private property for public use if needed for example in National Thermal Power Corporation at Tanda when they started extending their units they had means the government they took over the piece of lands of villagers and gave them money so you might have seen roads canals railways being constructed on fields owned by some individuals so you might have seen roads there are many types of roads national highway link roads metal roads canals there is Sharda canal and railways there is a railway line that has been constructed on which passenger trains and goods train run so they are constructed on fields owned by some individual when all these things resources were constructed so those people whose fields fell into this course they had to leave that to the nation to the government against it they are paid some amount urban development authorities get empowered by the government to acquire land in case of urban area in city area there is development authorities such as in Lucknow there is Lucknow development authority in Delhi there is Delhi development authority Awas Vikas system they have got power by the government to acquire land they can make colonies they can make parks they can make various other infrastructures for public use so all the minerals water resources forests wildlife land within the political boundaries and oceanic area up to 12 nautical miles from the coast termed as territorial water and resources there in belong to the nation means there are many types of minerals you know metallic minerals and non-metallic minerals we have water resources such as ponds river lakes forest we have huge forest say forest in Gujarat Gir forest and many other forest we have wildlife in this forest means many types of wild animals used to survive and land within the political boundaries there and the whole piece of land which is under India's political boundary or any country's political boundary and oceanic area what is oceanic area means ocean is extended across our coastal area but that oceanic area falls up to 12 nautical miles means 22.2 kilometer means 1 nautical mile is equal to 1.6 kilometer so 12 nautical miles will become 22.2 kilometer if we multiply 1.6 by 12 we will get 22.2 so up to 22.2 kilometers the area of ocean falls in the hand of that particular countries that is from the coast termed as territorial water and resources therein belong to the nation means that coastal area that is known as territorial water means within 22 kilometer from its coastal area that portion comes as a national property and it is natural resources. Here we can, you know, dig out various types of minerals or various types of gems, stones, and whatever, you know, aquatic animals are there. They are property of national area and it belongs to the nation. Last one is international resources. There are international institutions which regulate some resources. Means in our country, in all over world, we consider whole world, there are international institutions. Some institutions are those which are used by all over world, such as World Health Organization, International Monetary Fund, and various other institutions which regulate some resources. And these people, they used to regulate them. The oceanic resources beyond 200 nautical miles of the exclusive economic zone belong to open ocean, and no individual country can utilize these without the occurrence of international institutions. Means oceanic resources, means there are some resources which are oceanic, means beyond 22.2 kilometers, and or you can say that was a national resource, but beyond 200 nautical miles, that comes in the category of exclusive economic zone. If we consider a coastal area, then from that coastal area, 200 kilometer nautical miles away, 200 nautical miles away from that area, if we multiply 200 by 1.6, that much kilometer from that coastal area, that is no country's property. That is exclusive economic zone, and this exclusive economic zone can be used by any country. It is open ocean. Anybody can use to cultivate its resource. For example, China, it is extending its power in exclusive economic zone, and they are increasing their power, and other countries are worried about it. And no individual country can utilize this without the concurrence of international institutions. If we want to use exclusive economic zone, then we should take permission from international institutions such as UNO, United Nations Organization. But some countries, they are not taking permission and they are using it recklessly. So, do you know that India has got the right to mine manganese nodules from the bed of the Indian Ocean, from that area which lies beyond the exclusive economic zone? Of course, India has got permission from United Nations Organization to mine manganese nodules from the bed of the Indian Ocean, and they can extract this mineral from the ocean bed. Similarly, we have another various types of international resources in nature. These are many times, means after that you can say we can use another portion, glacier area. Now, on the basis of status of development, we can classify resources into four parts. First one is potential resources. Resources which are found in region but have not been utilized. Means there are many types of resources which are found in our state or country, but it could not be used. It is still in the same manner. For example, the western parts of India. If we consider western parts of India, particularly Rajasthan and Gujarat. Rajasthan is fully desert area, and Gujarat run of Kutch, it is totally unused area. They have enormous potential, means they have huge potential, means they can be utilized for the development of wind and solar energy. We can install windmill, we can install solar panel, but so far these have not been developed properly because we have not adequate technology, means technology is not available for us. So potential resources are those resources which are found in a particular area but they have not been utilized. Such resources are known as potential resources because of inadequate technology, means we don't have proper technology to use them. Second one is developed resources means resources which are surveyed and their quality and quantity have been determined for utilization, means those resources which has been kept in mind, means which has been recorded but their quality and quantity have been determined for utilization, and its quantity and quality they have been determined and it is utilized, we are using it. The development of resources depend on technology and level of their feasibility, because we can develop those resources only when we have proper technology and if can be used by everyone at a particular level, but it is so costly that we cannot use it, it is not feasible. Then comes stock. The last resource is, that is stock, materials in the environment which have the potential to satisfy human needs, means in our environment there are so many types of materials which have full capacity to satisfy our needs, but human beings do not have the appropriate technology. We are failed to develop such type of technology which can be used to convert these materials into useful things which cannot be used by everyone. They are included among stock. All these things they considered as stock.